Very good morning to all of you. Myself, Lalita Devi, PhD research scholar from Department of Chemistry, University of Jammu. Today, I'm going to discuss about organocatalyzed synthesis of bioactive nitrogen-containing heterocyclic compounds via CH bond activation under solvent-free conditions. First of all, I'm going to discuss about catalysis. Catalysis is the process of altering the rate of chemical reaction by the addition of very small quantity of a chemical substance known as catalyst that itself does not get consumed in the reaction but continue to act repeatedly. Catalysis is of three types, which are homogeneous catalysis, heterogeneous catalysis, and biocatalysis. Heterogeneous catalysts offer many advantages over their counterparts, such as these are non-toxic, recoverable, reusable, involve simple workup and less operation time. Moreover, they offer low energy cost. Polyaniline is one of the heterogeneous catalysts, having chemically flexible amine groups flanked either side by phenylene ring in a polymer backbone. Because of its very low solubility in many organic solvents and water, it is used as a heterogeneous solid acid support. The presence of various nitrogen atoms in penny provide a perfect handle for complexation with different metal ions, thereby providing a wide variety of catalytic applications. Because of its conducting nature, besides in organic synthesis, penny also finds its application in many other fields, such as in the storage of erasable optical information, in electrochemical capacitors, rechargeable batteries, in LEDs and sensors, and many more. These are the various literature reports in which polyaniline has been used as an efficient organocatalyst for various organic transformations. Now, quinoxylene is a heterocyclic compound comprising of benzene and the pyrazine rings. They display many biological activities such as antitubercular, antibacterial, antiprotozoan, antidepressant, anticancer, antiglaucoma, and many more. These are the various drugs known in the markets having quinoxylene moieties. Now, sterile quinoxylinones, these are the sterile quinoxylinones. Sterile quinoxylinones are the hybrid molecules of quinoxylene moiety and stilbene scaffolds. These are highly biologically active compounds and offer many pharmacologically activities such as antioxidant, anti-angiogenic, anti-parasitic, anti-inflammatory, antibacterial, anti-tumor, and many more. However, the literature reports, these are the various literature reports available in the literature for the synthesis of the sterile quinoxylinones, but they offer various disadvantages, such as they involve the use of sulfuric acid, acetic anhydride, excess aldehyde, and the use of piperidine, which is a toxic base. Moreover, they operate at longer reaction time, offer less yields, and operate at high temperature conditions. In light of these facts, to address these challenges, we wish to explore the use of the polyaniline as an heterogeneous organocatalyst for the synthesis of sterile quinoxylinones. So, in this direction, we carried out the reaction between 3-methyl quinoxylinone and aldehyde in the presence of the polyaniline. Various reaction was performed in both in the presence and the absence of the solvents. Delightfully, it was found that solvent reaction under solvent-free conditions gave the best yield. Now, the various amount of catalyst were also scanned for the reaction, and delightfully we found that 40 mg of the polyaniline gave the best yield. Now, these are the various highlights of the present methodology. This methodology offers good to excellent yield of the products, also easy product isolation, involve less reaction time, provide broad substrate scope, involves the use of eco-friendly catalyst, avoids use of acid or base and solvents, and many more. This is the plausible mechanism. First of all, an acid catalyst reaction occurs between the orthophenylenediamine and the sodium pyruvate to give the compound A. This compound undergoes intramolecular nucleophilic substitution to give the compound 1. This compound undergoes tautomerism to give the intermediate B. Now, polyaniline being a Lewis acid activates the carbonyl group of the aldehyde for the nucleophilic attack of the compound B to generate the intermediate D. Finally, dehydration of D furnishes the final product, which is the 3-methyl sterile phenoxylenone derivative. Now, after completion of the reaction, we proceed towards the recyclability of the catalyst. The catalyst, for this purpose, the catalyst was recovered simply by filtration and was used as such for a series of 6 consecutive runs. No appreciable drop in the yield of the product was found, indicating high stability and recyclability of polyaniline. This is the substrate scope of our reaction. Now, this is the proton NMR of the synthesized compound. The characteristic peak at about 12.5 ppm corresponds to the NH proton, and this spectrum is in good agreement with our proposed structure. This is the carbon-13 NMR spectrum of our synthesized compound. Now, conclusion. Polyaniline has been found to be an effective heterogeneous catalyst for the synthesis of 3 sterile quinoxylene to 1 H-ons from the 3 methyl quinoxylene to 1 H-on and aldehyde under solvent free conditions. The methodology is environmentally acceptable and the catalyst is readily recyclable and reusable. Thank you so much.